Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. In this video I'm going to show you how to create a simple Python Lambda function which we are going to deploy using AWS Lambda functions. Then we are going to create and connect an API gateway to the Lambda function. So we can simply do a post or a get request and then we can get the response from the Lambda function, which in this case is just an hello message. But then in this video, I'm going to show you something very useful, which I think is very useful at least, is how to add versions to the function and aliases. So later on in the API gateway, we are going to have different stages, and I apologize if I'm throwing all these technical terminology, because that's how it's called inside AWS. But then we're going to have two stages, so production and development, which are going to target a different version of our application. And that's going to be very handy. Let me show you an example. Here I have a URL that I can invoke. If I put dev, and then I'm going to put read, because this is our endpoint that we want. So here we can see that the development version, we are in version 2, and then in the production version, we are version 1. Of course, you will want to have a more complex code which returns something different. But if you want to be able to update your Lambda function without messing up what other people are using, then this is a very simple way to achieve that. You can have all your code base inside one Lambda function rather than having your code split across different Lambda functions. And you just have to change the URL in this way, like from production to development. And then this is going to be very handy. And then, of course, if you want to have read/something, this is going to be available both in production and development. So in order to do that, we are going to start from scratch. We are going to create a simple Lambda function. Then we are going to create an API. We are going to connect the API to the Lambda function using stage variables. And these stage variables are going to enable us to target one specific version. And then later on, I will show you how to release a new version as well and how you can connect to that. So the only thing that you are going to need for this tutorial is to have an AWS account. You need to be able to create a Lambda function, API gateways. And another thing that you are going to use is Cloud9, which is an online code editor that you can get inside the AWS management console. So if you go here inside the console home, you can click on Cloud9. I have already one Cloud9 created inside my AWS account, which I call it Cozy-app. And then we can open a IDE in the browser. This is going to be needed because we are going to be enabling the AWS gateway to send invocation to the Lambda function. So I will take you step by step and I will share all the useful code down in the video description. Please remember that if you like the content on the video, please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel. It really means a lot to me. And if you have any question, just let me know down in the comment section below. So let's start. So the first thing that we need to do is to go into the Lambda functions here, which we could have searched from the services. Here we could have clicked on Lambda. We have to select a region or a location, and then we just have to create a new Lambda function. So we can create a new Lambda function. So here I'm in Singapore, create a new Lambda function. I'm going to author from scratch. So my function is test YouTube. And then we are going to use Python version 3.9. Choose the latest version if you can. And then here we have to we just create a basic Lambda permission, so everything is fine with that. So you don't have to change the default execution role, and we don't have to change the advanced setting for the moment. So we're going to click on create function here at the bottom. Great, so this is our test YouTube function. Here we can see that this is the message, and we can get a status code of 200, and we just return a body with JSON dump hello from Lambda, and then we're going to say version 1. So we are going to deploy. Every time you make a change into the code, you need to deploy, and then we run a test. The first time we run a test, we need to create a new event, which we are going to call it, like we can call it simple test, doesn't really matter. And then here we don't really have to pass this variable, because in our case we just return a message anyway, and then we can press on save. As I said, we didn't need to have those key that we are passing. We can press on test, and here we can see hello from Lambda version 1. Great. So let's assume that this is all that we want. Of course, inside here we could have a more complex code, but then what we want to do is an action. Here we are going to publish a new version, and then the version description is optional. And this we can just say production, and this version 1 of our code. So we're going to publish this version. So that's great. We have created a version. The next step that we need to do is to go into action, and then we create an alias. The alias is going to be production, because this is the version of the code that we want to send to production, and we call production a version, which is the description, and we're going to target version 1, which was called prod. Okay, so we press on save, and everything should be fine. So we have our production version. Now let's go back into test YouTube, because we can no longer modify that code base, because that is the code in the production. But let's say that we want to also create a development version, which we can change and we can test, and you can also call it in a different way. So this is a Lambda version, and then we call it 2. 2 is the version of the code that, let's say we want to test it, we are not entirely sure it's working, but then it's going to supersede version 1 once we have tested into the development, and we are happy with it. So we can test it, we can see that everything is working. So we say hello, we see that we get a response hello from Lambda version 2. Now we have to do the last thing. So we're going to create an action. We're going to publish this new version, and this is going to be a version 2. Doesn't matter. And technically something more meaningful here, like you could describe the features, but it's optional, so I'm not going to add it this time. And then what I'm going to do here is an action. I'm going to create an alias, and we're going to call it development. So development is going to target version 2. So let's save and just recheck what we just have done, because technically we should have inside test YouTube here, we should have 2 aliases. So if I click here at the bottom, we should be able to see 2 aliases. One is production, that is connected to version 1. One is development, that is connected to version 2. So if I click here on production, I can just check the function here, and I can also test it. So if I want to, I can test it and can see what is the output. So if I press on test, this should be returning hello from Lambda version 1. Great. So now that we have set up our versions and our aliases, let's move to the API gateway. So the API gateway is going to enable us to create a URL that we can call, as we saw before, and then we can target the 2 different aliases that we have. So here we go inside API gateway, and we're going to create a new one. So here we go Amazon API gateway, which you could have gone through the services, through the console. Here we can see all our gateways as soon as it's going to load up here, and then we click on create API. So here we want to create a REST API that we can connect to a Lambda function. So we're going to click on build. So we are going to choose a REST, a new API. The new API, we are going to call it test-youtube-api. I like to call it like this because API tells me that is an API gateway, and test-youtube recalls the name of the Lambda function that we just created. So we can just create this API. Now that we have created an API, we need to create inside the action, we need to create a resource. The resource is going to be the path that we are going to use to call that Lambda function. So in this case, I want to read the data, let's say, and this is going to return that JSON string. The resource path is going to be read, and we can just click on create a resource. Great, so this has created the resource. Next thing is we need to do a create method. The create method could be, in our case, get. So in get, we can just press OK here. And then here we have to define a couple of things. So Lambda function, everything is fine. Here we say use Lambda proxy integration. Yes, the region, we are happy with this. So here what we need to do, we need to specify the Lambda function name, which is test YouTube colon. Then we need to say $ open curly braces, then stage variables. This is very important that you copy it as it is. And here we are not going to say URL, but we are going to say aliases. This part here, you can change it, okay? So you don't have to keep it as I wrote it, but we need to note it down. So if you're going to change it, you need to note it down, because later when we are going to create the stages, we are going to have to modify it over there in the stage variables. So let's click on save. And here is a message that is very important. This message is very important because we need to give the permission, okay, to this function to run, okay? So to this source ARN to run. So we just have to copy this message. Do not close this message here. We go inside Cloud9 and we paste this message. But before we run it, we are going to have to remove this part here that we added before from the $ to the curly braces. And over there, we are going to put the name of the aliases, okay? So the aliases were, one was development and the other one was production. So let's go back here in Cloud9 and we say production and we just press enter. Just check that you spell it correctly, so production. And then same again, we go here and we go to development. And we write development here. Development, and we press enter. Great. So we have production and development. We granted the permission, so we can go back to the API gateway and we can close this message here, and then we can click on save. Great. So last thing that we need to do is to have the deploy this action here. So we're going to deploy the API and we're going to create two stages. One stage which we can create from here is production, and we are going to deploy. And one stage, we can go back here, resources. And one stage is deploy the API and is production. And the other stage is the development dev. So deploy. Now, if you go inside stages, we have dev and production. The last thing that we need to do is to go here in dev, stage variables and other stage variables, and the stage variable was aliases, and the value is the name of the alias of the Lambda function. So inside dev is development and inside production is prod. So prod here, stage variable, add stage variable, aliases, and then we say production. Okay, so this is looking great. So I can press enter. Now I should be able to test this URL. So what we need to do? We need to click on this URL and then we need to go here into read. Let's see if everything is working. So we click here, prod is not working because we just gave the permission to do the read. And we see hello from Lambda version 1. And this is the production. But the development dev should say hello from Lambda version number 2. This is great. This is exactly what we wanted. So to recap, we can go inside here. We can still edit this code here, the main function, and this is not going to affect anything, neither the production nor the development version. But then we can target in our app, in our Python code, wherever you are running and connecting to this Lambda function, we can have switch between production and development by just changing this URL from dev to prod. I think that's great. And let's just see here that if I just want to show you that if in this function here, function test YouTube, I change to version 3, this is not going to be affected. So I can press on test. Actually, first I need to press on deploy. Then I can press on test here. So I can still do all my testing and neither the production nor the development is changing the code. So version 2 and prod is version 1. However, at one point, I may want to just deploy a new version, which is version 3. And we can do that. So let's do that. Action, publish a new version. This is, again, please add a description, so which is something meaningful. But now we can go into the aliases and we can change. We'll say that we have tested enough version 2 that now we want to have it in production. But version 3 now wants to be our development version. So we're going to test YouTube here. We can go into aliases. So in production, we want to edit it here. We can say edit. And now we no longer want to target version 1, but we want to target version 2 because we have tested version 2 and we are happy with it. So you can please press on save. And then we have also the development version, which is targeting version 2. So let's change that. We can click on edit here, and then we can target version 3. And then we can press on save. Now, if everything has worked and everything was fine, we should be able to see that when we do, we check the URL and we say dev, we should return version 3. When we check the URL saying prod is going to return version 2. Irrespectively of what we do in the code here, which we're going to change it right now, and we're going to say version 4, okay? So let's check that, and let's make sure that everything is fine. So here we're going to say version 4, because this is what we are actually testing. Here our code, this returns version 4, and should return version 4. Yes, here we can see version 4. But then if I go here, we say production, this should return version 2. And this returning version 2. And then if I press dev, here should return version 3. Nothing is returning either version 1, because now it's old, and we don't want to use that version, nor is returning version 4. I really hope you find this video interesting. I really hope I was clear and you were able to follow along with me. If you have any questions, please just let me know down in the comment section below. And if you like this video and you like the content of this video, please consider liking this video and subscribing to my channel. It really means a lot to me. You can also support this channel by supporting me on Patreon or by buying me a coffee. Find more information down in the video description below. Thank you very much for listening and see you in the next video.